What happens when you put together an aging desktop PC and a modern graphics card? Let's find out. My brother-in-law recently came to me saying that they were throwing out these old PCs that were due for refresh. So rather than let them go to waste, he sent them to me to check it out. I later found out that this was a Dell Optiplex 990 mini-tower PC, which was a Sandy Bridge-based CPU and also released in 2011. Over at the front, we have an old-school DVD drive, 4 USB ports, as well as microphone and headphone port. At the back, we have a mouse and keyboard port, 6 USB 3 ports, a display adapter, parallel ports, as well as a VGA port. No HDMI though. I really love how convenient it is to open up this case and all the components inside. There are no screws, you just need to click open the latch and then the case comes off. Unfortunately, the PSU is only listed at 265 watts. So we really have to be careful what components we put in. The CPU is an Intel i7-2600, and over to the right we have 4 sticks of 4GB DDR3 from Kingston, totaling 16 gigs. There is a pre-installed AMD HD 6350 GPU here, but we're not going to make use of that. This system comes with a 1TB 7.2K hard drive, so this is a good chance to put in an SSD. All in all, the specs of the system are good, but really what's missing is a modern GPU. For PCI expansions, there are no screws required. Just open the latch, put in your expansion, and slot it in. We are putting in an ASUS Phoenix 4GB GTX 1050 Ti graphics card. Installation is very easy. Once you have the latch open, just put it in the topmost PCI slot, the blue one. Once you've slotted it in, make sure that it's secure and you don't need to put in any screws, just close the latch. Once everything is nice and secure, putting back the CPU together is very, very easy. Just put the cover back in and make sure it's secure. The PC case came with a sticker installed on top with a key for Windows 7, which I used to install a fresh install of Windows 10 64-bit. For the final specs, for the CPU, we have a Intel i7-2600, 16GB of RAM, GTX 1050 Ti graphics card. So let's come to the part where you really came for, the benchmarks. First up is Batman Arkham Knight. Unfortunately, we can't get 60 FPS here on ultra settings, so we have to settle for low to medium settings. Next is Dirt Showdown. Even though it's a couple years old, it still looks very good. For esports, we have the very popular Dota 2. This doesn't require much in terms of performance.
Tracks it, Seer. Prepare for battle.
Good enough.
Silent as mist. Very well. Way ahead of you. Yes. My sentiments as well. First blood, and a point well taken.
For fighting games, the bare minimum requirement is 60 frames per second. So even if we put all the settings to very high ultra, this system really manages to still get those requirements. Our last benchmark is Rocket League, another popular esports title. Generally, esports titles don't require much in terms of performance, so we can see that here too. For a system that's pushing 6 years old, this CPU really still holds up in 2017. Modern and popular esports games still perform really well and look really good. I like how easy it was just to install a GTX 1050 Ti in there and not really putting in any new components apart from the new SSD. It was a very easy and straightforward process, and I really like how it came out.